Hello, Arequino Festival viewers. It's a great pleasure to welcome my guest, Sebastian Grobler, who is the director of the movie Lessons of a Dream. Hello, Sebastian.
Hello. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well. And thank you very much for meeting me today. I suppose you are very busy. I must confess that I was really surprised to discover your movie, because I just didn't expect it would be a costume movie. So it's not so popular nowadays, you know, and so I would like you to tell me a little bit about the genesis of the film. I know it's vaguely based on a life story of Konrad Koch, yes, who was a football pioneer from Germany, yes. But why did you find this story so important to tell?
Yes, let me point out, first of all, I like historical things or historical movies also. You're right, it's not so popular among today's viewers anymore so much. It depends a little bit on the country. If you, for example, live in England or you shoot films in England, it's very popular 19th century because it's their great century. I think Poland has also a big tradition, but I think maybe nowadays it's not so important as it used to be historical films anymore. I just discovered this story. And Konrad Koch was not very, very well known. There was a small book about it. And I discovered it because I was reading a doctor thesis about a PhD thesis about the story of English sports in Germany. And there I found his name, but just one or two sentences. And then I went on doing research and so on and so on. And the interesting part is really what the movie does. It's like 30 years of history kind of pushed together to Konrad Koch, because Konrad Koch actually had some difficulties, but not so much. He was playing with the students. Not everything that is told in the movie is really happened to him, but we kind of combined all the stories of certain pioneers. And the interesting thing is, you know, in Germany, football is very important. In Poland, it also gets more important now these days. It's a very important thing. And some people say it's the only thing that unites our society these days. You know, it's not anymore religion. It's really football. Football is very important. And actually, no one knows about that, knew about that, that in Germany, the first 30 or 40 years, the establishment was very much against football. So they did a lot of things to make it very difficult for football. It's really true that students, when they played in their pastime football, that they were expelled from schools. Yeah, you have to imagine that. And this happened in many cities, in many places. So they were expelled. It's something you had to do secretly. That is also told in the film. They found all kinds of laws to stop it. And it took actually almost until 1928 until it was allowed in some states and to play football in the sports class, you know, in a physical education class. You were not allowed to do that. Like Bavaria was the last German state, and now we have the famous football club in Germany, that's Bavaria Munich in 1928. It opened it up for football, but they said only 15 minutes of football, and a doctor had to be there. Yeah, with no sports, no physical education teaching without a doctor in football. And then we do evaluation 2 years, and then we decide if it's allowed. So it was very difficult the way with football in Germany. People don't know about it. This was the basic idea for the film. And then I I read all I could find about that. I read original, for example, magazines of teachers. For example, the big topic in these magazines I found was beating the students, you know, hitting them with a stick, you know, because a lot of parents were against that. And so the teachers union advised the teachers to do it, but not so harsh, because some parents said our kids cannot sleep anymore because they're beaten up in school. They have fear, you know. So there was around football in this time. Football can be seen as a symbol of the changing society, you know, industrialization. A lot of new ideas coming in, a lot of reformatory movements, also same in Poland, you know, different ways of housing, living, different ways of physical education. And this is kind of, you know, it was still a very divided society, also very rich people, very poor people. We came just out of pauperism in the 1860s. People were almost starving because they didn't have enough to eat in Germany. You have to imagine that. A lot of them went to the US. I think similar things in Poland. So I don't want to give a long history lesson now, but I think it was very, very interesting to discover that. I really had also a mission to show this, yeah, and also to show this kind of nationalism that was behind it, why they didn't want to have the English sport. Yeah, because in Germany, everyone did gymnastics. They had a movement of 8 million gymnastic people. They were very nationalist, and they were kind of doing this to prepare the kids for the war, yeah, mm-hmm. to prepare the soldiers, to make soldiers out of them. Mm-hmm.
So this story goes much beyond the sport, like a discipline, sport discipline. It's this topic is much larger, and yes, it was, I suppose, perceived as a rebel or culture revolution. And yes. What I found very important, because then I found out that this film premiered 10 years ago. However, this story is very timeless. And yes. this topic of prejudice or this openness towards different cultures is still as much important to nowadays as 10 years ago. So I really appreciate this as a larger perception. As we don't have so much time, so I have one last question, I'm afraid. I would like to ask you if you are a football player or a football fan.
These days, I'm more a football fan because my last attempts were not very successful. I always got hurt every week. So I was really thinking, oh my God, if you still want to walk in your life, better don't play anymore, when I was about around 40 years of age. And yeah, no, but I was a passionate football player. I grew up in the Ruhr area, which is a heavy industrial area, and we were playing every day. And this was really also the idea for the film, because we were in an area living where there were very rich kids, very poor kids, kids from other countries, like from Turkey, Italy. We were playing together. So this was my aim. So I knew the feeling, what it meant to play together. And later I played on the school team. And actually, my mother also forbid me to play football because it was a very proletarian sport in the 1980s, 70s when I grew up. And she said, no, you don't play football. You can play tennis or so, but don't football. But football was my passion. So, but at least I could play in the school team. And we showed also the movie, for example, to the national team of Germany. They all watched it, all the famous football player who became won world champions. And they were also very amazed, you know. Now it's today, you are stars, you make a lot of money. You know, what came out of this game? But we showed also in the movie with a lot of irony, you know, that how it will be. And, you know, the guy who sells the footballs, and that it will be a very capitalist thing. And but still, I think the spirit is still there, just playing on the street. Yeah, on you have a place you play, and people come together, and you form a team, and you do something together, and that's what I wanted to bring across with the movie. And it works very much internationally. It has won awards in Canada, in Korea, in Brazil. It's a very international language. And we try to make it also work for all times. Because if you do a historical movie, I hope it's a little bit like a classical movie now in Germany. So that's what we try to do. Yeah.
Thank you. And it's personal as well. And
yes. Yes.
Thank you very much. I see it even larger than before.
Yeah.
Thank you. I think just the football is a pretext to tell a much richer story at the end.
Yes, yes. Yes. So, a richer story about being together,
yes.
Coming over differences.
Yes.
Yeah, being strong as a kid, you can change the world. It's just a kid and a teacher, some kids and the teacher, and this is how it was. You know, you also Konrad Koch played with the students. Just imagine today that a teacher would play with the seventh graders. I don't know how much people would do that really in their pastime. He played for years. Yeah, so it was a group together. And also, you are not so much anymore the teacher, the kids, they're all together. And this is also how the first football clubs in Germany were all founded. They came all out of schools. And later on, they became very famous clubs in the world, football. It spreads also all around Europe. I was wondering, for example, I give you one last example. When FC Barcelona, everyone knows, Lionel Messi, yeah? They have a certain tradition. They have a certain shirt, you know, with these stripes. You remember? Yes. And I saw Basel, the football club of Basel, has the same stripe. And I was wondering. And the truth is that people from Basel founded FC Barcelona, Swiss people, because the England in summer came to Switzerland. The rich English, rich English schools for the rich English kids. And they played football. And then the Switzerland people picked it up. And there were some businessmen who did a lot of work in Barcelona from Switzerland. And they founded FC Barcelona, a big club. And that's why they have the same clothing. Yeah? Mm. So it's very international in some way.
Yes. Yeah, that's right. It's a very interesting
yeah.
topic. Okay, yeah. Thank you very much for your time and for this wonderful film. I hope we will be able to see one day at Ale Kino Festival. And yeah. Have a nice afternoon. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.